So this session is all about understanding how does the training industry works and what actions needs to be taken to have a regular source of income. Queries as well, you can always ask. I will take after the session if that is covered during the session. If not, then I will, we will discuss about it. And you can always get in touch with me personal one-to-one as well, all friends. So, okay. Let me start with, I interact with a lot of trainers and I have a fair idea what is the missing factor, what challenges, what they face. To start with, what happens is, even if you are an individual trainer, look at your business as an organization. That's the first part. So this specific service or a product, a service for a specific target audience. In training business, you can have B2B and B2C services. What is B2B, business to business, is corporates and education institutes can buy your services. What is B2C? B2C, direct consumers can buy your services. These are the services any trainer should have, B2B and B2C. That's the first step for a specific target audience. Once you have this B2B, you can have three topics, 1, 2, 3. These are the three topics which are, it could be executive presence, decision making, innovation, creative, whatever. These are 2, 3 topics you got. B2C, you can have various services, a 500 rupees service. It could be, your online modules, 500 to 2000. It could be online modules. It could be your one-to-one sessions. It could be your one-day sessions, whatever. Second service in the range of 15 to 25,000, it could be your certification program. It could be a boot camp. It could be outbound retreat program. Third service in the range of 50,000 to 1 lakh. What I'm just telling you is have various services for the consumers who can buy your services for their specific target. I'm just talking about the structure. Just see the entire structure. If some elements is missing in this structure, then rethink on it and try to, because some parts you will say, this is not for me, as if this is not for me. An organization will have all these things. Sooner or later, you'll require these elements. So I'll first talk about the structural part. First, I spoke about a services, a B2B service as a B2C services. So when you are starting as well, creating these services, you have to be very specific about the target audience whom you want to give these services. Suppose I have services for trainers, for corporate, for society people, but I'm not prepared now to go to, with all my services to corporate and to, society. So initially, whatever you are prepared with, so I was preparing for trainers, so I have the services for trainers. So yeah, I'll start with this. So be very clear, I'll start with this, then move on to this and this. So be very clear, what are your services? That's a first step of the structure. Our organization will have a services for a specific target audience, B2B and B2C. The second part is, any organization or individual trainer should have a vision. Where am I heading towards? What is going to happen with you in 10 years or 15 years or 20 years? What is the milestone which you are looking at? That milestones have to be defined. For me, it is, by 9th of September 2034, I want to impact 1 crore people. That 1 crore people, out of that 1 crore people, there will be 3 lakh trainers, 5 lakh corporate, 92 lakh of society people, whatever. A fair idea, where exactly you want to go, a vision. Your personal vision, you frame it the way you want to frame it. You share it with the world, this is my vision. At least they understand what this person wants to do. Okay, an organization will have a services. Second, you will have a vision. Okay, this is where, I want to reach out to. Third, we'll have a mission. Why are you doing what you are doing? That why has to be very strong. Why? Why are you doing what you are doing? For me, my mission is now is learning and earning for trainers. This I eat, drink, breathe for what I do. In the last 1.5 months, we have been crazily working to create some services for the specific needs of the target audience. Organization will have a mission. So first I spoke about the services. Second, I spoke about the vision. Third, I spoke about the mission. This is the mission which I'm working upon. And share it with the world. Let people laugh. you know, when I say, you know, I'm going to build a 5,000 crore company, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this, people will laugh it out and let them enjoy their laugh. You keep on working on your goals. That's it. Once service is defined, vision defined, mission defined, then come values. Build your organization, build yourself on certain value system. My value system is scale, sharing, caring, achievement, learning, enjoyment. People who know me closely will say, I live every single value of mine. I share a lot of insights with a lot of trainers. I care for a lot of people. I have achievement oriented. I want numbers to be achieved. I always talk about with trainers about the numbers, achievement, and learning. I keep on learning. I keep on watching videos and courses and blah, blah, blah for me to know, hey, am I in the right direction? Learning and enjoyment. I enjoy whatever I do. Now also I'm enjoying. To live and work and see that how are you practicing these values every single day of your life? These values are not on papers. You know, people who are working with me very closely will know that, you know, I ask them about the values, how you have lived the organizational values or how you have lived the values in your day-to-day life. For me, it has to be practiced every single day. So till now, what we have covered, any organization will have services defined, vision, mission, as well as we spoke about the values what an organization should have. Once you have this, any organization will have seven departments. The first department is marketing department. If you are a single, like alone you are doing the business as a solopreneur, what you can do, write your name at every department of the organization. Okay, the first department, marketing, write your name. I'll write my name. Oh, Asif will take care of it. Okay, Asif. I'll talk about every department, but I'll go one by one and of what is the role of a marketing department? The marketing department's role is to get you leads for your services, which you have defined, which I spoke about. That person should get you leads. Tell them how many leads you want. Suppose I have a program coming up. I tell my marketing department, I want 10 leads. Train that marketing department. How does a leads come in? Okay. So what that person needs to write, blogs, articles, blah, 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 whatever the marketing department. You can ask me, okay, what are the roles of a marketing department to generate leads? The first department, marketing department. Suppose that person has generated you 15 leads, the first department. That comes to the second department. This is the sales department. Now write your name in each and every department. The second department is sales, wherein what happens is 15 calls you have received and 15 leads what you have received, you'll speak to that person. And this sales department will close. Sales department will close that sales. Out of 15 leads, 7 were closed, 8 were closed, none were closed, or all were closed. If he's not able to close that, probably he doesn't know about the selling skills and all. Train the department on that selling skills. The second department. The third department is the operations part. Here comes the trainer's role, actually, the operations part. The trainer will go and do the training programs, take feedback. All that comes under operation department, the third. This department is good for most of the trainers. But for most of the trainers, the marketing and sales department is not. The operation department can't do anything if these two departments are not working properly. You know, they don't understand their role. The third department, write your name at each department every now and then. Otherwise, you will feel, oh, this is not for me. This is for an organization. The third department is the operation department. The fourth department is innovation department or research and development department. And they... Every product of yours should evolve over a period of time, because what I launched 5 years back can't be the same right now. As well as depending upon the market scenario, now COVID situation, everything is online. So you have to create some online products and services. So you have to change this innovation department or research and development department role is to look into your existing services as well as what new services, what we have done for last 1.5 months, we have completely stopped live membership of Learners Conclave. No members, 1.5 months. We have evolved, we try to find out what are the challenges of a trainer. You know, there are three segments of trainers: emerging trainers, evolving trainers, established trainers. Emerging trainers wanted more of, you know, content and skills building. Evolving trainers more of skill building. They wanted more of marketing. So we redesigned everything which we'll be launching in this week. So you will get evolved over a period of time. Because when you interact with customers, they'll understand, okay, what are the needs, what are the challenges. Accordingly, you will create those services of yours. So I was talking about the fourth department, which is the research and development innovation department. Then comes your HR. HR department will actually see what are the KRAs and KPIs of every department. And which department is doing well, which department is not doing well. If they are not doing well, why they are not doing well? Have you defined what will the parameters? How can you say which department is? So as well as whom to train, what to train, any new resources to be added, all that will be taken by this department. Fifth department. Sixth department, a very critical department, is the finance department. As a person, you know, you have to be very clear about what would be the total revenue. I said B2B services, B2C services, and different price segments. So you have, suppose, 2,000 wala service. I give to 500 people, I'll get 10 lakhs. I've got 15,000, I'll give to this many with this many lakhs, this one. That clarity, get total revenue, what I'm generating in next 1 year. Depending upon the goals you have taken, okay, you have to work hard accordingly. So finance department, what will be the total revenue? What will be the expenses? And what will be the, you know, net profit? That finance department, sixth department. Seventh department is the management. And this is where your role lies. Initially, you will be there in each and every department doing a lot of other things. Even I have done it and I'm doing it now as well. Slowly, slowly, you will move to management. Management, you will have an advisory board. You know where the organization is standing right now. What is the revenue? Where you want to see 1 year, 5 year, 3 years. Every quarterly, you will review your performance. What went right? What went wrong? So that clarity of where do you stand now, that's management. That's management. So if you have this framework structure ready, then you will be, everyone knows heart in heart, where do they lack. First of all, don't worry even if your every department is not up to the mark. No one starts with a bang, which all the departments and blah, blah, blah. First, you have to understand, what is it I need to work upon? And work on that craft. And what has happened is a couple of trainers have started very well. And they said, oh yeah, I need to do marketing for my services. They started doing marketing. They did one or two webinars and they didn't got any leads from the webinars. Then they asked if I don't get leads of other webinars and all. Understand this. It will take its own time. And don't be, you know, it's like, you know, sowing a seed and I want fruits. As if fruits are not coming. It takes its own time, depending upon what chapter. Everyone is at a different chapter. Everyone is at a different phase of life, phase of business. If you have not built your tribe, how will people get to know about you? If you are building your tribe. So marketing, actually, it's like consistent efforts over a period of time. People who know me that I've been doing this for 5 years now, consistently over a period of time. That's marketing, of having your services defined, redefined, consistent. Regularly, are you doing webinars or Facebook lives, sharing your knowledge with the world? Are you posting every single day on platforms where your target audience is present? Every single day. Are you sending out requests to your target audience on LinkedIn and other platforms every single day? Are you connecting one-to-one with your target audience every single day? Don't worry if they are not buying your services. I repeat, don't worry. You keep on building your tribe. Now my reach is around 14,205. This year I'm going to reach to 1 lakh people. If I have a 1 lakh people ka reach with me, if I want 25 participants, how many seconds it will take? It will take hardly any seconds. If you really keep on building your tribe, building your services, re-look into it. So everyone is at a different phase of life. It's consistency that is more important. Can be consistently doing certain things in a certain way. I think I've given a structure to what it is. You ask me any questions and I will be more than happy to, you know, share my insights about how things happen and what are the challenges what you are facing. So if you have any queries, you can write. Otherwise, you can have my number 9967352331. So anyways, so if you have a number with me, so I just shared my insights, and marketing is a consistent effort. And if you wish to learn about marketing, we have this service is happening starting from this January, this Sunday onwards. It's a 1 year program, 45 days extensive training followed by a hand holding for the next 1 year. And if you don't double your income, money back guaranteed. If you want on a piece of paper, I can write it on a piece of paper. But you have to work the way I'm telling you to work, because it's consistent efforts over a period of time. Like just doing for some time and not doing it, it is not going to affect. It's not going to, you know, yield that desired results. And have belief. The most important thing which I tell all trainers is have belief in yourself. Even if the world is not believing you, it's fine. You have belief in yourself and keep working. It's like a, you know, farmer who is sowing a seed, and he doesn't think about, you know, storm aega, rainfall aega, ye hoga, insects aega, ye aega, mera crops kharab. Before that itself, you are thinking so many things ki aisa hoga, waisa hoga. Have belief in yourself. Work on your craft. Work on your services, and things will be fine. So thank you so much. Had a great time with you all. Hope you learned something, and looking forward to work with you all. Thank you.